Hi, this is John. In this IT Taster video, I'm going to show you how to install and configure Active Directory Domain Services with Windows Server 2012. If you're new to Active Directory, Active Directory enables us to build a Microsoft network that is scalable. It centralizes administration, takes care of things like user logons, security permissions, and provides important network services. Okay, the server I'm working on is a standalone server, but by installing Active Directory Domain Services, we're going to make the server a domain controller. Now, before installing Active Directory, we need to make sure the server has been given a meaningful name and assigned a fixed IP address, otherwise we'll have issues later on. Now, this can be done through the new Server Manager. If you click on Local Server, click on the computer name, click Change. There you've got the option to give your server a meaningful name. I've chosen Server 1. Now if we go back to Server Manager and click on Ethernet, right click on Network Adapter and choose Properties. Now in this video I'm working with IP version 4, so if we choose IP version 4 and choose Properties, there we can assign our server a fixed IP address. I'm using 192.168.0.210 with a default Class C subnet mask. I'm using my router as the default gateway and the DNS server at this stage. In Windows Server 2012, most of your administration will be done using the new Server Manager. It's a little different from the old Server Manager we're used to in Windows Server 2008 because we can manage multiple servers and their roles and features from here. Now, to install Active Directory Domain Services, we need to click Manage. Click Add Roles and Features to bring up the Add Roles and Features wizard. Now this screen basically tells us what the wizard does and also a useful reminder to give our server a static IP address. And we need to click Next. We need to stick with role-based or feature-based installation and click Next. Now if you've got multiple servers, you need to select the server that you want to install the role to. I've got just the one, and click Next. Choose Active Directory Domain Services and you're prompted to add features that are required by Active Directory Domain Services, so click Add Features. Now notice in the upper right hand corner we're shown the server that we're installing the role on. This is very useful when you're working with multiple servers. And click Next. On the Select Features screen we simply need to click Next. Now this screen tells us what Active Directory Domain Services does, and it also recommends we install a minimum of 2 domain controllers for resilience, which is good practice. Now should a domain controller fail and go offline, the other domain controller will continue to deal with user logins, etc. And also additional domain controllers help distribute things like user logins and demands on network services, and this is particularly useful in larger network environments. When you're ready, click Next. On the Confirm Installation Selection screen, put a tick in Restart Destination Server Automatically if required, and click Yes to confirm. Now we can export our configuration settings to an XML file if we want to, and this allows us to automate this part of the installation should we need to repeat it on multiple servers. When you're ready, click Install. Now at this stage, Windows is installing the installation binaries only, and we're reminded that additional steps are required to make the server a domain controller. Now it's worth mentioning if you worked with previous versions of Windows Server, we needed to run a command called dcpromo to perform the next stage of the Active Directory installation. The graphical dcpromo command has been taken out of Windows Server 2012 and is relocated to Server Manager. Okay, I've speeded things up a little here. Our Active Directory Domain Services binary installation is now complete. We're reminded that additional steps are required to make this machine a domain controller, and we can now close the wizard. Now you notice at the top of the screen we have a notification in Server Manager, and if we click on it, it tells us configuration is required for Active Directory Domain Services at Server 1, and we need to click Promote this server to a domain controller. I'm going to create a brand new installation of Active Directory. So I'm going to create a new forest and a new forest root domain. If you're not too familiar with Active Directory forests and domains, why not take a look at my Active Directory overview video on the IT Taster channel. Now I need to choose add a new forest, and I need to specify the root domain. Now it's recommended that you don't create a new Active Directory forest with the same domain name as your external DNS domain name. I'm going to specify a private internal domain name by adding .local to the end of it. And I'm going to use ittaster.local and click Next. We need to select the forest and domain functional level. Functional levels determine domain controller capabilities and, importantly, the supported operating systems the domain controllers can run. But functional levels don't determine the operating systems you're able to run on servers that are not domain controllers. The forest functional level applies to all domains and domain controllers in the forest and is the minimum functional level. The domain functional level applies to domain controllers within the domain. It cannot be set lower than the forest functional level, but it can be set higher. Now, forest and domain functional levels should be set as high as possible, and they can be raised later, but make sure all of your domain controllers are supported, so do your homework first. I'm not going to be working with any legacy domain controllers, so I'm going to leave the forest and domain functional levels set at Windows Server 2012. DNS has been selected for us. A Microsoft Dynamic DNS server is needed for Active Directory. The Global Catalog Server option is ticked and greyed out because we must have at least one Global Catalog Server. And the Read Only Domain Controller option is unticked and greyed out because our first domain controller cannot be a Read Only Domain Controller. And finally, we need to specify a password for our Directory Services Restore mode. This is very important should you need to perform an Active Directory recovery. And click Next. We get a warning telling us a delegation for this DNS server cannot be created, and this is because we've not yet installed DNS, so we can click Next. Here our NetBIOS domain name is verified, and we're also given the option to change it if necessary. Now the NetBIOS domain naming convention is a pre-Windows 2000 technology, but it's remained in use and can still be required by some applications and network devices. And click Next. Here you can specify alternative locations for the Active Directory database, log files and the sysfol folder. I'm going to stick with the defaults and click Next. We can review our settings, and we've also got the option to export our settings to a PowerShell script. And click Next. The prerequisite check is complete and it tells us all prerequisite checks have passed successfully. We've got a couple of warnings down here, but these are to be expected when you perform the installation of a brand new Active Directory forest. So we can go ahead and click Install. At the end of the installation, the server signs off and will reboot. We're back in Server Manager and we now have an Active Directory Domain Services role installed as well as DNS. If we go to the local server, we now have an ittaster.local domain. And if we go to the Tools menu, there are the tools we need to administer Active Directory. We now have a Windows Server 2012 domain controller. I hope this video has been helpful. Please subscribe to the IT Taster channel. Comments are welcome, and thanks very much for watching.